In this video, I'm going to show you 23 of the best Excel shortcuts that you can start using today to save time. Let's get started. First one, if you want to select your entire data set, just click inside of it and press Ctrl A. If you want to select an entire column, just click within that column and press Ctrl Space. If you want to select an entire row, just click within that row and press Shift Space. Now, let's say you want to navigate to the top left corner of your dataset. All you have to do is press Ctrl Home. And if you want to go to the opposite side, the bottom right corner, just press Ctrl End. Now, let's say you want to jump from one side of your table to the other side of it. All you have to do is hold Ctrl and press an arrow key. For example, if I want to jump from the bottom here to the top, I could press Ctrl Up arrow. And if I want to go from here to the left side, I can press Ctrl Left arrow. Now, this doesn't just work for the corners of your table, it works for any edge. So let's go down over here and say we want to jump from here to the right side, we can hold Ctrl Right arrow. And if you want to select everything in your path while you make these jumps, just add a shift in the combo. So, for example, if I wanted to select the top row by jumping from the left to the right, I could press Ctrl Shift Right arrow. You can also use this combo to select an entire column. For example, let's say I'm at the employee ID column and I want to select it. Just press Ctrl Shift Down arrow. As you jump to the bottom, it'll select everything in your path. This next shortcut is one of my favorites. So let's go over here, and as you can see, we have a table here with a bunch of messy column widths. And instead of manually adjusting every single one like this, you can just click inside your table and press Ctrl A to select it, like we said before, and then press Alt H O I. This automatically adjusts all your column widths. Now, as you can see from this table, the row lengths are still a bit iffy, so instead of manually adjusting all of those, you can press Alt-H-O-A. Now that we have a clean table here, let's go ahead and add some filters. How do you add filters? Just press Ctrl-Shift-L, boom, now you got some drop-down filters that are 100% functional. Speaking of functional, how do we turn this table into an actual functional table that Excel recognizes? Well, just click inside of it and press Ctrl-T, then click OK, and that's it. We got a functional table here that Excel recognizes. Now let's use some more shortcuts on our table. Let's say we want to add a row. How do you do that? Just select a row and press Ctrl-Shift-Plus. Now, if we want to delete a row, you just select that row and press Ctrl minus. Now, let's say we want to move a row around. How do you do that? You hold shift and you drag the edge around like that. Now, let's say we want to take this table and turn it into a chart in its own separate sheet. How do you do that? Just click inside of it and press Fn F11. Boom, you got a separate chart in its own sheet. All right, let's go back to our table. Let's say that we want to hide some columns. How do you hide a column? You just select the column and press Ctrl 0. If you want to hide multiple columns at once, just select the columns you want to hide and then press Ctrl 0. Now, if you want to hide a row, all you do is select the row and press Ctrl 9. Now, if you forget which rows and columns you hid, don't worry, you can always find them by pressing Alt semicolon. When you do that, you'll see some lines that indicate where your hidden columns and rows are. For example, you can see that this line clearly indicates that there's a hidden column here. So I can go ahead and double click here to unhide my column. And as you can see from the lines, we have a hidden row here. We can go ahead and double click here to unhide that row. We have another hidden column here, which we can double click. And it looks like we got one more, so we can double click here to unhide that column. Here's a quick little shortcut. If you want to insert the current time, you can press Ctrl Shift semicolon. And if you want to insert the current date, you can just press Ctrl semicolon. Now, I'm going to finish off this video with three super powerful Excel shortcuts. The first one is for removing duplicates. For example, let's say I have a table here that has a bunch of duplicate rows. How do you go about removing these duplicate rows? Well, all you gotta do is click inside your table and press Alt AM, then click OK, and boom, all of your duplicate rows are automatically removed. Alright, the next shortcut is for auto summing. Let's say that you have a bunch of tables and you have to find the row sums and the column sums, but you don't feel like typing the sum function over and over again. Well, instead of doing that, you can just select your first table, then press Ctrl, hold it down, and select the other tables. Then once all your tables are selected, you can just press Alt equals. That auto sums all your rows and columns for you. Now, this last shortcut is personally my favorite. Let's say we have a list of names over here and we want to separate them into a list of first names, a list of last names, and their emails. How do you do that? For the first names, all you have to do is type the first name, press Enter, and Control E. That's it. And for the last names, it's the same thing. You just type the first last name, press Enter, and Control E. Now, when you press Control E, Excel recognizes a pattern in your data and autofills the rest of your list. So, by using that same logic, we can also combine the names and make an email. For example, if I type the first name, then the last name, and let's go ahead and add it at gmail.com, and press Enter. And like always, add a Control E, and boom, we have our list of emails. There you go. Those are 23 super useful Excel shortcuts that you can start using today to save time. If you feel overwhelmed by this video, don't worry, you're not alone. I know what it's like trying to learn all these new shortcuts. It's definitely not easy in the beginning, but in the end, it's 100% worth it. You'll be able to work more efficiently and save so much time. So again, don't worry, just keep on practicing and you'll get there. Plus, to make it easier for you, I created a PDF guide with all these Excel shortcuts and more for you to print out and use as a reference guide until you don't need one anymore. So if you want to go ahead and get my guide, I put a link to it in the description below this video. All you have to do is click on it and enter your email. Once you do that, my guide will be delivered directly to your promotions tab in your email. Alright, that's all I have for you today. I hope you found this video useful. And if you want to see more quick Excel tutorials like this one, make sure to subscribe and let me know in the comments.